In this lesson, we're going to cover topics to create a graph with computational logic using an attractor algorithm. While an attractor algorithm sounds intimidating, it is simply a mathematical approach to driving geometry by proximity to any given point that is considered an attractor point. By the end of this lesson, you will reinforce your understanding of lacing, learn how to create an attractor algorithm, and learn new ways to interact with dynamo geometry. For the attractor algorithm, we want to create an object that will react based on an attractor point. Attractors are really fun algorithms and can be employed in a variety of ways. A great use case is for facade design or laying out solar panels based on their angle to a given object. For this example, we're going to go ahead and start a new blank workspace and ensure that our run mode is on automatic. As a reminder, the run mode is in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, and you can toggle it by selecting the drop-down. Using automatic run mode for this use case is great because we want to see our Dynamo graph update live within the viewport. To get started building the graph, we're going to create a grid of points with a point-by-coordinates node. The point-by-coordinates node can be found in the geometry category in the library. So we'll navigate to Geometry, Points, Point. As you can see, there are a few options here. We're going to use the Point by Coordinates XYZ option for this workflow. With this node placed on the canvas, and since we are on Run Automatic, Dynamo's automatically placing a point in the background. Once again, we can notice that the inputs for this node have a default value of 0. This is indicated by the thin blue line next to the input ports. Additionally, hovering on the input ports will tell us what the default value is. In order to make this dynamic and create a whole grid of points, we're going to create a number range as covered in previous lessons. A range node lets you create a number sequence with a start value, end value, and step value. Nodes to create sequences or ranges are found under the list category. So we'll collapse geometry, navigate to list, generate. We'll go ahead and pick range, and we'll place this node now. Upon placement, the range node also has default values. Our default values consist of 0 for the start, 9 for the end, and a step value of 1. For our range output, we are going to go ahead and use this on the X and Y input ports of the point by coordinates node. For our range output, we are going to go ahead and connect this to our X, Y input ports of the point by coordinates node. We'll make the connection with X, hold down Control on our keyboard to duplicate that input into the Y value. Selecting a blank spot on our workspace will finish this command. As you can see in the background preview of Dynamo, we do have an angled line of points. By default, our point by coordinates node is making the shortest connection based on the lacing. In a previous lesson, we discussed lacing concepts and the different options available. For us to develop a grid of points, we need to navigate to the ellipses button on the point by coordinates node and change the lacing to cross product. By changing the cross product, this allows us to create a grid of points. We are able to navigate the background 3D geometry preview by holding down the escape key on our keyboard and holding down the right mouse button to orbit. At this point, you can position the background preview to get a better view. In addition to this navigation option, we can click the geometry icon in the upper right corner of the canvas or by pressing Ctrl B on our keyboard to switch to the background 3D preview. In order to make this more interesting at this point, we're going to go ahead and change the start value, the end value, and the step value. For the start and end values, we are going to use two number nodes. Let's go ahead and search for the number node by right-clicking on the canvas. Once we have one number node placed, we can hold down the Control key and drag copy to create another copy of it. For the outputs of these number nodes, the first number node will be our start value. The second number node will be our end value. We'll change that value to an ending value of 20. This creates a large group of points. Now, in order to see this update dynamically, we're going to use a slider node. To find a slider node, we can use the in canvas search once again. By searching for slider, we can find a number slider node as an option. The number slider consists of a few default values. If we would like to customize those values, we can click the blue arrow dropdown and modify them. In our case, we don't want anyone to be able to input a value of 0, so we'll change the minimum to 1. And for the max value, let's make it something slightly smaller. We'll go with 10 for now. This is changeable later, so don't worry about it quite yet. And for the step value, we will leave it at 0.1. And we'll collapse the inputs whenever we're done. This number slider's output will be the input for the step of our range node. So let's go ahead and connect that now. If you left the value at 1, you won't see any changes made quite yet. But as we modify our slider, we will notice the density of the points change. This interaction is really great because we get to see the updates live. In order to make this graph more clear, we will rename our number nodes. In this case, we will rename the nodes to represent where they are connected in the range node. The first number node will be start, and the second number node will be end. In addition to the number nodes, we'll rename the number slider step. This enables users of our graph to understand what the nodes are controlling directly. In order to clean this up even more, we can go ahead and create a group for these nodes. We will select the two number nodes and the number slider, and with all three nodes selected, we'll press Ctrl G on our keyboard to create a group. For the title of this group, we'll call it Inputs, and we'll leave the description blank for now. For the object we are controlling, we are going to use circles. Circle creation is available in the Geometry category in the library. We'll navigate to Geometry, Curves, and we have the Circle category. Within the Circle category, we have an option to create a circle by center point and radius. By placing this node, and since we are in Run Automatic, we will see a circle appear at the origin of our Dynamo graph. This is due to the default values for this node. Hovering on the input ports, we will see that we have a point at 0, 0, 0, and a radius of 1. For our use, we want to create circles at each point in the point grid that we have generated. So we will go ahead and drag this node to the right and connect the output of our point by coordinates node to the center point input of the circle by center point radius node. By default, the radius is a value of 1, which results in several circles with a radius of 1 in the background preview. As we work within Dynamo, we might not want to have the previous geometry that we have created visible for us. In this case, we don't want to see the points anymore. We want to see the circles that we're creating. Luckily, we're able to hide geometry being created by nodes. This option is available either through the right-click menu on a node and selecting Preview, or by selecting the ellipses button and selecting Preview. At this point, an eye with a cross through it appears on the node, indicating that the geometry is hidden in the background 3D preview. For these circles to be controlled computationally, we want to control their radius based on their proximity to an attractor. In order to build an attractor point, we can go ahead and search for an additional point by coordinates node. We'll go ahead and right-click search, point, dot, and by coordinates should show up. We'll use the XYZ option once again. And like before, we will see a new point at the origin being created. Since we hid our initial point by coordinates that we were creating, this one is visible and it has grip handles on it. With those grip handles, we will now modify this point with a feature known as direct manipulation. If we select the point by coordinates node and navigate the background 3D preview, either by holding down escape or toggling to it with the shortcut or the icon, we will notice that we have those grip handles available to us as we pan and orbit. If we select any of these arrows and drag our mouse cursor, we will notice that the point moves and our inputs on the point by coordinates node will receive variable inputs in the form of number sliders. It places them by default, so you might have to reorganize them a little bit. These nodes are being created based on direct manipulation. Direct manipulation is fulfilling these inputs for us. This is a really quick way to place number sliders for our point by coordinates node. For this node, we will leave that points preview on because we want to see and manipulate it. In Dynamo, there are a lot of options available that work between geometry of all types. We navigate to the geometry category and the modifiers category. We are able to explore interactions between geometries. In this specific case, we want to see how far the circles on the grid are from that given attractor point. Luckily, in Dynamo, there is a node called distance2. The description of this node is as follows: obtain the distance from this geometry to another. This node does not have any default inputs, resulting in red lines on the input ports. The first input will be the output on our original point by coordinates node. Let's connect that now. The second input will be the output of our second point by coordinates node for our attractor point. In order to make this more clear, let's go ahead and create a group on the attractor point nodes. Once again, we'll select the nodes involved, these two number sliders and the point by coordinates node, and we will go ahead and create a group. Press Ctrl G on our keyboard to create the group, and we'll title this attractor point. And for the description, we will enter attractor point to control radii. To further observe what our geometry.distance2 node is doing, we can pin the output of this. This is achieved by hovering over the node, navigating to the flyout, and pressing the pin icon. Now we can visualize this node's output live as we make changes. Note, this can also be achieved with a watch node. What's really great about previewing this node's output is as we make changes with direct manipulation, which we can do by selecting a node and holding down escape to navigate the preview, we can see those changes happen live. So now we'll see that node updating as we drag the grip handles. To further visualize what this is doing, we will now connect the output of the geometry.distance2 node to our circle by center point radius node. We're going to connect this now to our radius input. It is very likely that the current background preview is going to look kind of crazy right now. This is due to the circles receiving very large radii. We will address these sizes next. Within Dynamo, we have access to numerous mathematical operations. These are all available under the math category in the library. Let's navigate there now. We'll go to Math, Functions, and we'll see all the functions available to us. In this case, we can find a node called Remap Range. The Remap Range node's description is: adjust the range of a list of numbers while preserving the distribution ratio. This node is great because it will maintain the proportions to one another while we are using our algorithm. We'll go ahead and place this node now and drag it over to the right. For our use case, Remap is great because it allows us to fix the circle's radius to not ever be a zero value and also to not overlap. For now, we're going to use two number nodes. Let's search for and place those now. And I'm just going to go ahead and do a copy with a control copy to get two of these nodes. And for our minimum value, we're going to use 0.25. We'll plug that into new min. And for our maximum value, we're going to go ahead and type in a value of 1. We'll plug that in now as well. The numbers that we are remapping are the numbers from our geometry.distance2 node. We'll make that connection, and the output of remap range will go into the radius of our circle by center point radius. Now as we interact with our attractor point, either by sliding the sliders or using direct manipulation, we will start to see our circles update based on those values that we just created. So now I'll go ahead and select the point by coordinates node, go to the background preview, and move the point around. And as we move the point, we will see those circles update based on their distance to that attractor point. At this point, if we were to modify the step size or the start and end of our original grid of points, we will see that update as well. Let's go ahead and try that now. For step, we'll drag this to be a little tighter. And eventually you'll start to see circles overlapping. This is because we modified our step size to result in circles that can overlap based on that maximum radius value. Let's go ahead and fix that now. In order to prevent overlapping, we're going to use a division node. This can be found by simply searching for the forward slash within the search menu. So we'll right click, and we'll search for forward slash and place a division node. The input for X will be our step number slider. So we'll go ahead and take that slider and connect it to X. And the Y value will be a numerical value of 2. Now we have an algorithm that updates based on that step size and is all tied together. Zooming out, we can see all the nodes involved in this algorithm. So now as we change our step value, our circles will never overlap. So we can change our step value, and we can also change our point location by using direct manipulation once again. In order to clean this up a little bit more, let's go ahead and group some more nodes. So we'll go ahead and select the geometry distance to, the number nodes involved, and the remap range. And we'll press Ctrl G on our keyboard. We'll organize it a little bit better. And we'll title this Calculates Distance. And for the description, we can be a little bit more specific here. And we can say Attractor Calculation Based on Distances. An additional feature of groups is we can now collapse these groups when we don't need to pay attention to them. For instance, this calculates distance group, we don't need to see all of the nodes, so we can collapse that with the little arrow in the upper right corner of the group. So we'll collapse that one now. And the other ones, we have some inputs available, so we'll go ahead and leave those expanded. And there we have it. At this point, you have a graph that is an attractor algorithm that now reacts to the input values of the point by coordinates grid that we're generating. It is also tied together where it will react dynamically to graph updates. In this video, we covered the following: how to create a point grid with cross product lacing. We developed an attractor algorithm with circles that respond dynamically based on distances. And we learned about direct manipulation within the Dynamo viewport. With this lesson complete, you have an understanding of how to add computational logic to your Dynamo graph and create a great user experience using direct manipulation. I encourage you to expand upon this graph and explore what other use cases you can find with attractors.